Hey guys, I'm so excited because this is actually my first episode. Looks like it's gonna rain. I'm just now leaving work, Bass Pro. It's like walking a mile to your car from the store. There's my car. Ooh, it's hot in here. Throw down these windows. I'm gonna turn on the AC, put it on full blast. I am sweating inside my car. It's like I walked right inside the oven. Dang, cars. Why don't you just pull out in front of me and let me hit your ass? Damn. People need to learn how to fucking drive. Like, y'all saw me coming and y'all ended up almost hitting me. Yeah, your front bumper of your fucking car looks like it's been torn off. Can we stop making me slam on brakes? I need a haircut. Maybe I can give myself one when I get home. Always traffic. School traffic. You better let me get through. Thank you all that. I remember the first time there was school traffic. School had just now started. I got off at 4:30 and it took me an hour to get home. I was like, can I just go home? Of course there's a cop car. Every time there's a cop car, there's always something. The cop is actually out there directing traffic. I hate when they... It's like you got all that room, you couldn't just wait, just get to a turn lane. Have me on the edge of the fucking road. What's wrong with people? People in Macon do not know how to fucking drive. I can tell you that right now. I mean, I used to live up in Atlanta. That was where all the crazy shit happened. At least it cooled down in this car. I can tell you in Macon, Georgia, there is a lot of construction going on. At least it's not too much traffic. Oh my God, what's taking so long? Why is the traffic light so still on red? Stuck in a red light for like 10 minutes. Now I'm about to go. I'm breaking a sweat. Carly fan. All right, I'm home. Now I gotta open the gate. My remote is messed up, so I have to keep pressing the button like 20 times to open the damn gate. Hush! Y'all bark too much.
All right, I'm home. I just walked in the door, about to go give myself a haircut. I really need one because this hair right here is very thick. Every time I put like shampoo in my hair, that's just the clippers that you guys heard that fell off. So if you was to put shampoo in it, it will not get inside the scalp. And then every day I have to scratch and hit my head so many times just so it would not itch. If you have an itchy hair, then you know what I'm talking about. Ooh, I kind of do like this. I kind of do. What do you guys think? I kind of like that. Maybe one day that will be like my new little thing one day. Because I kind of like how this thing is around. It look like, that would be a really good idea. I can have me a new hairstyle. That's actually a really good idea. But for now, I'm not going to go too crazy on that. The only thing I don't like about a haircut is that it gets inside of your clothes. But it's not like I'm gonna wear this uniform every day. I mean, I got others. I can tell you the only thing I do like about haircuts though, you feel a lot better. Hair is getting all up inside my nose and it's, For the last couple haircuts I did, I kept missing a few spots and then I was like, I had like a little bit of string on the top of the edge right here that made me look like alfalfa. And then I had a few strings, you know, here. And then it was like the next day I had to like home and had to fix it. Even though it still looked pretty good, you couldn't even tell that there was stuff sticking up, especially when it's on camera. See, whenever you give yourself a haircut, you gotta actually like kind of feel around, make sure nothing's sticking up, you know, make sure no little strings hair are loose, like this one right here on my head. All right, what do you guys think? I think it looks good. Look at all this hair. This is from my head. Oh, it feels so much better. Oh, it feels so much better just getting this off my head. Whenever I get done giving myself a haircut at night, I go and take me a shower. So since I'm now out of the shower, I'm gonna go ahead and make my lunch because that's what I do every day when I go to work. Ooh, I forgot I have these chips in here. I got these from the break room. Hey, Meow Meow. Meow. You guys, this is Meow Meow. I didn't name her, my sister did. It's actually her cat, but my sister doesn't live here. But she is what you call a kitchen cat. That's basically why she's kind of fat. Ain't that right? Say, you're a kitchen cat. You have to have food. Ain't that right? Meow. So what are we gonna have for lunch tomorrow? Meow meow, what are we gonna have for lunch tomorrow? I don't know either. Come here. Here, why don't you tell the audience what we should eat tomorrow. She says, I don't care as long as it's good. She said, can we have cat food for lunch tomorrow? I don't know if I want cat food. Should we get mac and cheese? What about spaghetti? Soup? Maybe like chicken noodle soup or something? We'll figure it out. Let's have some lemon berry squeeze to drink for lunch tomorrow. I don't care what anybody says, I love these Hawaiian punches, especially the regular one where it just says red punch or whatever it is. Oh my gosh, so good. I've always loved these kind of drinks. Ooh, how about a snack? How about one of these little Ritz handy snacks? It's like finger foods, but in snacks. Meow meow, we still haven't figured out what we want for lunch tomorrow. What are we gonna eat for lunch tomorrow? I don't know either. Meow. Guys, look at this. This cup is like a barrel, and I got it for $25 with my discount. It's an Orca. And I noticed about with this top, look, I don't know if y'all can see it, but it kind of looks like one of those dolphin tails. And it's a 12-ounce cup. Guys, there's still hair in my nose from when I was shaving my head. You know what, meow meow? I think I know what I want. Let's have some spaghetti. It's gonna get eaten anyway. I mean, I know it's a lot, but I'm probably gonna get starving after that. I don't know if you guys remember, but when I was doing a cooking video, I think I was making a pizza, I think. And then I was telling you that, like, what I like in my spaghetti noodles versus the spaghetti cup.
You know those little spaghetti cups that have, like, just the Chef Boyardee in them and the spaghetti already in it? That's what I like. It's just the spaghetti cups in them. But then whenever I start making noodles, like spaghetti noodles, I'll start adding like Parmesan and butter in just the regular spaghetti noodles that you actually can cook on the stove.
I would seriously put this butter in the refrigerator without a top. I'm not gonna worry about heating it up because, well, they have a microwave in the break room, so I'm not gonna worry about it. The reason why I make my lunch is because, well, I don't have money. And we're actually being timed when it comes to being on lunch. Like, most jobs, you'll have to get, let's say, a 30-minute break. We would have to go all the way to the break room, clock out, walk 5 minutes from the break room to our cars, and we have to walk like a mile to our cars to get to our cars. We have to drive to a restaurant, which we'd take up the entire break. And then you have like 5 minutes left to eat your food when you bring it back to the store. So it's like the whole 30 minutes, it's like you don't have enough time. That's why I always bring my lunch, so I have plenty of time to eat. I'm gonna put this in the fridge. Okay, meow meow, thank you so much for helping me. I wanna say thank you so much. You helped me make my food. See, tell her she did a really good job helping me figure out what to eat for lunch tomorrow. You did a good job. Sometimes we can just order food from DoorDash and they will just deliver it to us at the store. All right, y'all, I'm about to go to bed. I'm off tomorrow, so you might get to see more of the show. Good night. All right, it is now the next day. I'm fixing to go shopping and I'm about to take you guys with me. Ooh, it's kind of smoky out here today. Stinks out here. Somebody must have like started a fire or something. It looks foggy out here, especially with that smoke. I didn't realize there was a subway over there. All right, I'm here. Let's go shopping. They rearranged this Walmart where you can't find nothing. All right, first things on the list, chapsticks. Actually, I think the chapsticks would be at the register, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know where I'm going. Actually, I think they would be right here where the pharmacy would be at. Let me check the other side. Looks like I might be wrong. They've rearranged this entire store. I swear, I cannot find anything anymore. Last time I came over here, I had to ask for help. And they didn't even know where the stuff is. That's because you rearranged the damn store. Oh, here's the cosmetics right here. I think cosmetics is more like beauty supply, grooming. I doubt they have chapstick. I might be wrong though. I might be wrong, unless I'm not looking. Well, I might have to get some from the register. All right, let me pull up on what's next on my list. I think the sunglasses would be in the jewelry department because that's where they always keep all those sunglasses. Here we are. Sunglasses. They really don't have much. Well, what do you guys think about these? I kind of like them. How much are these? $14.97. That's not bad. Here's another pair. Let's see what's next on my list. So the next thing on the list is socks. I'm just gonna throw my old socks in the trash because right now they're just not feeling right. Might need a pack. Okay. How many's in here? 12? socks. Get maybe a black pair in a pack. Wait, found some. Here's some right here. Black socks. Let's see what's next. Next is to look at some Nintendo Switch games. Because apparently I feel like I've been getting scammed from Nintendo because I bought two $25 games thinking that they were actual games. But when I open up that game, it wants me to pay another $60 to add to that game. Which is stupid. Like, why would you even make a game that's gonna cost like $25 and then you want us to pay $60 more? Like, no, I'm not paying $100 for that shit. No. Like, Nintendo, you need to fix that. And to top it off, you can't even get your money back. That's a fucking ripoff. Let's see here. See what kind of games I can get. Friday the 13th video game. I love scary. It's actually more fun to actually get scared. Now, I know I saw something online. They said they had a SpongeBob game for like $20. They may not have it. I might have to order the game. Wait, what's over here? Okay, here's a good games. They got Family Feud, Ben 10. I was never really a big Ben 10 fan. This is the one I saw. Yeah, I saw this one online. Let's see what else we got. Ooh, what's the Ice Age one? I think I might have played this on the computer. That's actually not bad for a game, actually, no. Jumanji, the video game, that would be maybe a good game. They even have a Paw Patrol video game. Cameron loves Paw Patrol, but I don't know if he knows how to play a video game. He's only 2 years old. I think that's all I see right now. Maybe for my birthday, I might ask, maybe my sister can maybe get me some like video games. That'd be a good idea. Animal Crossing, I might ask for that. Maybe for my birthday. I might get Animal Crossing for my birthday. I mean, I probably won't keep these boxes because the Nintendo Switch I have it in, I got a case and it looks like you can actually put games in it. Now, I gotta go to the register, grab my chapsticks, and then check out. Found the chapsticks and they were in the pharmacy where I was at earlier. This is what I got in my cart. Let's check out. So this is what I was talking about earlier. This is the case for my Nintendo Switch. As you guys can tell, I put my games in here, like the 3 games I got. You guys, it's time to go swimming. Today we're gonna go a little old school. That's that old school shit. Trying to find me a floaty to lay on, and well, we don't have any more for this year. We have some, they're torn up. Thank you.
my daughter no more.